Hey guys, what's up? At the moment, we are busy getting some stuffs going for some good old PlayStation classics. What the hell is Sonic Mega Jump? What's that nonsense? Didn't cover it. Like we said, we are doing winter 98. Let's just hope we're not getting any drop frames detected. But yeah, apparently this particular issue, he goes in. You can get the demon ghost or whatever. No shit.
I'm working too hard for these things. I gotta subscribe.
You too can subscribe. 4 times a year, you get 2 CDs packed to the hilt with game demos, video interviews, event footage, downloads, and more. All this for only $29.95 a year. In the meantime, check out this issue of the Underground Jampack and see what you've been missing.
Alright, so we got some deeper things behind the scenes. Something for the download station.
Oh.
Sword Art guy, he's a cult.
When you make a game, all you start with is a blank piece of paper and a few big ideas.
I wanted to see a game that was in full 3D, but where the primary focus of the game would be interaction with the enemies. To the best of my knowledge, that had never been done before.
How do you end up with a video game world that pulls you in? How can you make it stand out from other games? Your team will hit development walls and have to search for breakthroughs. Here's the inside story of the making of Spyro the Dragon, and an exclusive tour for the PlayStation Underground.
The most difficult part was the beginning, determining what kind of game we were going to do after Disruptor. Craig Stitt said, you know, I've always wanted to do a game about a dragon.
I've always loved dragons. To me, they are just the greatest creature. I mean, it's the combination of a Tyrannosaurus Rex with wings and breathes fire. I mean, you've got the best of everything in a dragon.
And immediately everybody said, yeah, that's it. Because dragons can fly, they can run, they can flame, they can jump, they can do anything, and they're cool.
In the game, you play the part of Spyro. An evil creature named Nasty Nork has cast a spell turning all other dragons into crystal statues.
You have three major objectives in the game. The first is to rescue all the dragons, the second is to collect the treasure that Nasty has stolen from the dragons, and the third goal is to defeat Nasty himself.
Designer Mark Cerny had come from such games as Disruptor, the Crash Bandicoot series, and Marble Madness. In Spyro, he had new ground he wanted to cover.
I had this idea that you could do a panoramic 3D engine on the Sony PlayStation, where there wouldn't be any fog in the distance. And I challenged Alex Hastings to create such an engine.
Most of what it takes to pull off that sort of panoramic engine, it comes around in, you know, assembly draw routines.
In fact, I told him very specifically how to go about creating it. He blew me off and did something totally different. But it turned out much better than what I had in mind.
Engine to draw the environments has broken down into seven different little renderers that work on different levels of detail of the environment to try to keep this, you know, the fact that you're seeing a quarter of a mile away and what would be tens of thousands of polygons into something more manageable.
Because not only did you have these big, long views where anything in the universe could be seen from afar, but also he created an engine where you could have detail on the objects that were close.
The real trick is that in every transition we try to do is a fade or morph transition, something where you're not gonna see it.
I think there's never been a console video game where you got both of those. He had to write some damn good code.
The fact that this game is coded specifically for the PlayStation is probably our biggest advantage. When you compare it to, say, a PC or other console platform, down to the PlayStation, it's really different. The things it can do well is it can draw an enormous number of polygons. Some of those guys have 5,000 polygons in them. You'd never try to do that on any other console.
Well, I think the flying levels really were a surprise for us. Everybody loved it. We made sure that we had more of them.
I play the flying rounds, the free flight rounds over and over again, trying to, you know, get through all the obstacles in the shortest amount of time and trying different paths to see if I can beat the record. I can easily waste an hour or two doing that, not even realizing.
The DualShock analog controller really allows a great feel and a good freedom of control. You can just point it any direction you want and you're going there. And they've integrated the feedback in there too. You can ram yourself into a wall and you'll just feel it come back at you.
The game also has features especially for hardcore gamers.
In every single instance where you can super dash, there is a secret place you can get to. That is our challenge to all the really good players out there. Not to go out and buy a hint guide or read about in the magazines, but to find out for themselves where it is they go, what it is they can do.
Another feature that pulls you in is the soundtrack. Spyro includes some well-known voices.
Don't worry, the only one who's gonna be trapped is him.
When we were putting together the voice of Spyro, we talked to Carlos Alazaki first, and
Mabel,
last,
us.
It turned out.
I think we went through about maybe five or six versions, you know, where
He was like really, really young and had Lionel up in the nose. And then he's like really cool and older, and they actually recorded something like that. And then they found out he was too mean. So then we just kind of did a mixture in between the two, where it's kind of like he's really kind of a go-getter kind of guy and kind of tough, but really kind of nice.
Be on the lookout for no commandos, Spyro.
The other big voice part of the game is with the dragon. One of the voices that we've relied upon a lot is Clancy Brown, who's a well-known actor who was in Starship Troopers.
The dragons are free from their custody. They give them advice and tell them how to play the game cryptically. You know, to teach him how to fly, how to use the buttons, where to go, what to say, who to do, who he has to fight, who he doesn't have to fight.
As soundtrack and gameplay come together, is Spyro a world that pulls you in? It's already had an effect on the team.
Actually, now, if you walk around the office, a lot of people speak in the voices of the characters.
What?
What?
You can put that on the tape, I know. That's the only thing I would have on
there. Aw, guys. Got the doggo to deal with.
Oh boy. Yeah, I don't even know if
thank you.
Okay, hold on, guys. I think I have to go and, I don't speak animal. Alright, I'm finally back, y'all. And let's just say Texas is too damn hot. Let's see if that helps any. What else can help against this frame drop situation? Trying to figure out a bunch of other things here that might help with streaming. Although I have a feeling best bet's gonna be alright, so still have one viewer. See about Spyro. Okay, so you're still going on here.
Thank you for releasing me. Free the dragons in the artisan world, then seek out the balloonist. He'll transport you to the next world.
What about Nasty North?
That's all I can tell you.
What about this?
Okay, so it doesn't look like we have any I'll have to check back with the footage later, but yeah. This is actually one of the few games for original PlayStation that have actually aged quite well, all things considered.
Now we're down to zero viewers. Probably no one's interested in the Spyro. I think there is a way to get up there. I'm just kind of lost to it as of now. Hey, what's up? What's up, nerd? Yeah, it's been a while. Yeah, I know. I haven't been on a Discord server in a while. I don't know. I've just been kind of in a funk for a bit. Don't know why exactly. I just, you know. That's weird. Well, then again, saying I have drop frames, I don't know what the fuck that means. Unless that means I need to get, see here. 49% detected drop frames. Like, I'm trying to see here what might be causing it, but I have some weird little feeling that
it's something to do with disk space, which I'm kind of running out of, to be frank. Like, I need to get another 5 terabyte drive. Okay, let's get to another game here that's on the demo. Spyro, I've played the living shit out of as a kid, so. And I've had the real game of that. Never played a demo version. Didn't seem like much affected her than some stuff's restricted off. You know, your typical 90s demo stuff. See here. Metal Gear Solid. Let's go with that. Cause what is this? Oh, there we go. I've actually played a good chunk of this. I played the demo of this enough times to know just about everything. Yeah, tell me if anything's happening when during this cutscene here.
Nuclear weapons disposal facility on Shadow Moses Island in Alaska's Fox Archipelago was attacked and captured by Next Generation Special Forces, being led by members of Foxhound. They're demanding that the government turn over the remains of Big Boss, and they say that if their demands are not met within 24 hours, they'll launch a nuclear weapon. You'll have two mission objectives. First, you're to rescue DARPA Chief Donald Anderson and the President of Armstech, Kenneth Baker. Both are being held as hostages. Secondly, you're to investigate whether or not the terrorists have the ability to make a nuclear strike and stop them if they do.
What's the insertion method?
We'll approach the disposal facility by sub. Launch a one-man SDV. After the SDV gets as close as it can, dispose of it. From there on, you'll have to swim. High-tech Special Forces Unit Foxhound, your former unit, and one that I was a commander of.
So they're still around.
There are 6 members of Foxhound involved in this terrorist activity. Psycho Mantis, with his powerful psychic abilities. Sniper Wolf, the beautiful and deadly sharpshooter. Decoy Octopus, master of disguise.
Not much I can tell you on what to do about the buffering.
And Revolver.
Because it's working fine here.
Specialist in interrogation.
Me watching streams and stuff.
Gunfighter. And finally, charge of them, Foxhound squad leader, Liquid Snake.
Liquid Snake?
The man with the same code name as you. The nuclear weapons disposal facility covers the whole island. I'll instruct you by codec after you reach your target.
Anyone going with me?
As usual, this is a one-man infiltration mission.
Weapons and equipment OSP?
Yes. This is a top secret black op. Don't expect any official support.
Yeah, that's what I figured. If I couldn't help you on your being able to watch this stream, but hey, what you gonna do?
This is Snake. Colonel, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface. But make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
Got it. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Okay, if you turn on... analog controls. It kind of helps, actually.
Crawl in the direction you want.
Be careful, though. Crawling is slow, and you can't attack when you're doing it either.
You can stand up by pressing the crawl button again.
I'm just gonna fuck these guys. Good servers. Oh, thank you. About two guards here. All of which I can easily take out. Okay, so there's only two guys here. So, in theory, yeah, there we go. Oh yeah, funny note when you have cigarettes.
Are you smoking?
Yeah, so what?
Didn't you know that cigarettes contain benzopyrene, a chemical that leads to lung cancer? We now know that when benzopyrene enters the body, it changes to benzopyrene diol epoxide, BPDE, and attaches to the receptors on the P53 gene, the gene which causes lung cancer. The BPDE attaches to the P53 gene in three specific locations and causes precancerous changes to the lung tissue.
You know a lot about science, but you don't know how good a cigarette tastes in the morning.
In all seriousness, it is actually killing you in game, so the only time to really use those is for laser beam traps. Well, go back your way, good sir. That's what I was talking about. Just choke him out. Except for that, there's no more guards. Ah, he was the last one. And you'd think it would just stop the demo at that portion, but no. Hold on, guys.
I'm full.
Ooh.
Are you still alive?
Yeah, I'm still alive.
I just got home from the pool and I'm freezing.
Yeah, like we just got out. Yeah, I'm just going through the Metal Gear Solid demo right now on this disc.
It's Snake.
Yeah.
I'm in front of
the
disposal facility.
Tell him how she freaks out whenever I come home.
That took a long time.
Oh yeah.
I guess you're feeling a little rusty. Don't worry. It's been a while, but it's all coming back to me.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy. I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh?
Come,
by the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
Are you talking to Nerd?
Yeah, he was on here.
I was wondering who all those messages were from.
Behind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no
idea. No, because he's streaming.
But it looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed. There are only 18 hours left until their deadline. You've got to hurry.
Well, you must be crazy to fly behind in this kind of weather.
Who's that?
Oh, sorry. I haven't introduced you to yet. This is Mei Ling. She was assigned to us as our visual and data processing specialist. She designed your codec, as well as your Soliton radar system. Contact her if you have any questions about either of them.
Nice to meet you, Snake. It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just didn't expect a world-class designer of military technology to be so cute.
You're just flattering me.
No, I'm serious. Well, I know I won't be bored for the next 18 hours.
Come on. I can't believe I'm being hit on by the famous Solid Snake. But I'm surprised. You're very frank for a trained killer.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend. But first, let me explain about your Soliton radar system. The bright dot in the middle is you, Snake. The red dots are your enemies, and the blue cone shape represents
their
field of
vision. Okay, so sweetheart just came back home.
Be careful, Snake. The genome soldiers have highly developed senses of hearing and vision due to their gene therapy. Make sure you don't let them see you.
First, I want you to infiltrate the disposal site and look for the DARPA chief.
The DARPA chief was injected with the same GPS transmitting nanomachines as you. He should appear on your radar as a green dot.
Get whatever information you can from him about the terrorists. If he's alive, that is.
Snake, your radar isn't affected by the weather, but if you're discovered by an enemy, you won't be able to use it.
Yes, it gets jammed easily, I'm afraid.
Yes, it's all made from currently existing technology. You won't be able to use it in an area with strong harmonic resonance, so be careful.
We'll be monitoring your movements by radar, so contact us by codec anytime you want.
Got it. I'll call if I'm feeling lonely.
Seriously, Snake, we're here to back you up, so call if you need some information or advice. I'm also in charge of your mission data. Contact me if you want me to record your current status. My frequency is 140.96. It's a dedicated frequency for saving data. Don't forget it.
Remember, except for your binoculars, you're naked. You need to arm yourself with whatever weapons you can find.
I remember. First, I'm strip searched by Dr. Naomi here, and then all my weapons are taken away. Imagine yourself put in that position.
Well, if you make it back in one piece, maybe I'll let you do a strip search on me.
I'll hold you to that, Doctor. By the way, sorry to disappoint you, but I did manage to smuggle out my smokes.
How did you do that?
In my stomach. Thanks to the shot you gave me that suppressed my stomach acids.
Cigarettes? How are those going to help you?
You never know.
If you want to get in, there's the front door. It's the fastest way, but there's too much risk of being spotted by the enemy.
I can't just knock on the door and ask them to let me in. There's one sentry on the left and one on the right. They're armed with 5.56ers and pineapples.
What in the name of...
What about the air duct near the door? There should also be a duct on the second floor.
Yeah?
Look at my hand.
I can't see it from here.
Do you see the skin?
Yeah.
Coming off just when I do this?
Yes.
I'll let you decide the best COA.
I have no clue what's going on.
I'm counting on you, Snake.
I can tell you what's going on.
What?
I've got dead skin on my hands.
Oh, probably from a sunburn.
Or because I haven't used lotion or a scrubby in like a month. Although I do have a bit of bleeding right here because I did have a cut right there. I think I need to use some lotion on my
hands. What is it, Snake?
Feet right now. Are the exact same way.
Snake, remember what the
Snake,
girl said.
You want me to
the
come
graveyards
out there?
Are full of indispensable men. Snake, you're all alone and surrounded by bad guys. Try to be careful and avoid getting into a fight whenever you can.
You're right. Wow, you know all sorts of great quotes, don't you?
Yeah. Both my parents are from Guangdong, China, but I was born and raised in America. I've always liked reading literature from both
Death
sides.
Kind of keeps me in touch.
I'll share some more quotes with
you. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, apparently.
To tell you the truth,
that's our cousin.
I'd like to learn more about you.
Okay.
Well, I'll think about it.
You owe me a big hug when I get home.
Yep, thanks. Alright, now we got the Sukhon.
What can I do for you, Snake? Talk to you later, Snake.
Good. You've got yourself a weapon. To use it, first hold down the R2 button to enter weapon mode. Then select the weapon you want with the directional button. After you've selected the weapon you want, let go of the R2 button to exit weapon mode. The weapon you selected should appear in your hand. To use the weapon, follow the directions displayed in the window. If you use the R1 button, you can equip your weapon more quickly. While you're barehanded, press the R1 button to equip the last weapon you used. Press the R1 button while you're holding a weapon to be barehanded again. Don't fire your gun needlessly, or you might be discovered. If you had a gun with a suppressor, it would be a different story. If you have any questions about weapons or equipment, you should ask our military analyst, Nastasha. Her frequency is 141.52.
This is Nastasha Romanenko. A pleasure to work with you, Solid Snake.
You're the nuclear specialist that the Colonel mentioned?
That's me. You can ask me anything about nukes that you want. I am also a military analyst, so I have an extensive knowledge of weapon systems as well. They asked me to participate in this operation as a supervisor from the Nuclear Emergency Search Team. I was happy to accept. We must not allow terrorists to get their hands on nuclear weapons of any kind. I hope I can help you to stop them.
You're a tough lady.
Those terrorists are serious about launching a nuclear weapon? The world cannot stand by idly and allow that to happen, and neither can I. Unfortunately, all I can do from here is provide you with information.
Hopefully that'll be enough. Another soldier here wouldn't make a difference anyway. It's good to work with you, Nastasha.
Same here, Snake.
Surveillance camera?
Snake, this is McDonald Miller. It's been a long time.
Master, what are you doing here?
I quit being a drill instructor, so I moved out here for some peace and quiet. I'm in retirement, just like you. Once in a while, I still help train the Alaskan scouts.
Passing on the skills to a new generation, huh?
Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival in a harsh environment. I've lived in Alaska longer than you.
Thank you.
Use the elevator to change floors. There should be a cargo elevator that you can take down somewhere around there. Try to find it.
Move the dark machine to the cell in the first floor basement.
What about the vent shaft cleaning?
They just opened the vent covers. They're about to start spraying for rats.
First floor basement ventilation shaft.
Shut those covers as soon as they're done spraying. Also, keep your eye on that woman in the cell. Don't get careless now.
Woman in the cell? Did something happen?
There's an intruder.
Really?
He's already done three people.
He's killed three people?
Yeah. Say he's using stealth, too.
Stealth? There's an intruder besides me?
Anyway, I want you to increase the security detail on the chief.
Snake, didn't you hear that the DARPA chief was moved to a cell in the first floor basement?
Look at the radar. It's picking up the DARPA chief. He's the green dot. Hurry and rescue him.
not him.
Snake, the DARPA chief's signal is coming from somewhere in that area. Isn't there some place to drop down? Take a look around in first-person view mode.
Save you. You're the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson, right?
You here to save me, huh? What's your outfit?
I'm the pawn they sent here to save your worthless butt.
Really? It's true. You don't look like one of them. In that case, hurry up and get me out of here.
Slow down. Don't worry. First, I want some information about the terrorists.
The terrorists?
Do they really have the ability to launch a nuke?
What are you talking about?
The terrorists are threatening the White House. They say if they don't accede to their demands, they'll launch a nuclear weapon.
Sweet Jesus.
Is it possible?
It's possible. They could launch a nuke.
How do they plan to launch? I thought this place was just for keeping the dismantled warheads. They shouldn't have access to a missile.
What I'm about to tell you is classified information. Okay? We're conducting exercises with a new type of experimental weapon. A weapon that will change the world.
What?
A weapon with the ability to launch a nuclear attack from any place on the face of the Earth. A nuclear-equipped walking battle tank.
Metal Gear. It can't be.
You knew? Metal Gear is one of the most secret black projects. How did you know that?
We've had a couple of run-ins in the past. So that's the reason you were here at this disposal site?
Why else would I come to a godforsaken place like this?
I had heard the Metal Gear project was scrapped.
On the contrary, it's grown into a huge joint project between ArmsTech and ourselves. We were going to use this exercise as raw data and then proceed to mass production. If it hadn't been for the revolution.
Revolution?
Rex has fallen into the hands of terrorists.
Rex.
Metal Gear Rex. The code name for the new Metal Gear prototype. They're probably already finished arming the warhead they plan to use with Rex. These guys are pros. They're all experienced in handling and equipping weapons.
Hey! Shut up in there, will ya?
But I thought that all nuclear warheads were equipped with safety measures. Some kind of detonation code that you have to input.
Oh, you mean PAL. Yes, of course, there is a PAL. It's set up so that you need to input two different passwords in order to launch the device.
There are two passwords?
Yes. Baker knows one, and I know one.
Baker? The president of ArmsTech.
That's right. Each of us needs to input our password, or there can be no launch. But they found out my password.
You talked?
Psychomantis can read people's minds. You can't resist.
Psychomantis?
One of the members of Foxhound. He has psychic powers.
This is bad.
It's just a matter of time before they get Baker's too.
If they find out Baker's password.
Yes, they'll be able to launch a nuke anytime. But there is a way to stop the launch.
What?
The card keys.
Card keys?
They were designed by Armstead, the system developers, as an emergency override. Even without the passwords, you can just insert the card keys and engage the safety lock.
And if I do that?
Yes. You can stop the launch.
That card key.
So where are the keys?
Baker should have them. Listen, you need 3 card keys. There are 3 different slots to put them in. You need to insert a card into each one of them.
Okay, 3 card keys. Do you know where they might be keeping Baker?
Somewhere in the second floor basement.
Second floor basement?
I heard the guards say they moved him to an area that has a lot of electronic jamming.
Any other clues?
Yes. They cemented over the entrances, but didn't have enough time to paint them. Why don't you look for the areas where the walls are a different color? Here, take this. It's my ID card. It'll open any level 1 security door. It's called a PAN card. It works together with your body's own electrical field.
Personal area network, huh?
It transmits data using the salts in your body as the transmission medium. As you approach the door's security devices, they'll read the data stored in the card.
And the doors will open automatically. Gotcha. Okay, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
You haven't heard any other way to disarm the PAL, have you? From your bosses or anyone?
No.
Are you sure you haven't heard anything?
I just said no.
So does the White House plan to give in to the terrorists' demands?
That's their problem. It has nothing to do with my orders.
But what about the Pentagon?
Pentagon? What is it?
Why?
What's that? Hey, what happened?
To be continued. Alright, so that finishes Milker. That's probably the longest portion of the demo disc. Thank you. die, B. Lance, get the fuck out of here. And you stupid spiders, too. Get out of here. It's the anthill. This game, I heard, is actually supposed to be getting a reboot.
It has risen again, Sir Daniel Fortescue, see? The hero of Gallimere who fell at the first charge. The fog of war and the shrouds of time conspire to turn the arrow fodder into the savior of the day. Forget the ignoble truth. A chance to defeat Zarok and live up to the legend. We hopes it does well.
I have no clue what the fuck I'm even doing. Tell me I can't go back into the Shrine of Resurrection. For those who are about to say the saints and all that. Well, I mean, look at the story beginning plot here. The dude dies and then comes back in a crypt of some sort. You know, it's basically the Shrine of Resurrection when you think about it.
Thank you.
Shit. Fucking trees.
Thank you.
Yeah, the controls are kind of something to be desired. Something left to be desired.
Thus came the end. Thank you.
Yeah, I think that's junk. And I'm sort of dreading one particular... I'm just dreading Rallycross too. NFL Game Day and NHL Face-Off, I don't mind. Those are sports games I can get behind. Rallycross? Oh god. For those who weren't here, for me demoing, or showing off the demo for Rallycross 1, like, oh god, it was horrible. Broncos versus the Packers. Let's see how this goes.
Welcome to the Rocky Mountain city of Denver, Colorado, home of the Denver Broncos. Today they face the Green Bay Packers. Hello, I'm Dick Enberg, along with my partner, Phil Sims.
Denver needs big plays today in this game, Dick, and I think the safeties could be the weak link. I wouldn't be surprised to see them tested deep and often.
There's barely much for commentary, like, what the hell? That's it. Gets it. Broncos down, first and 10. Thank you. Yeah, no one's gonna score by this team. That was back in a golden era. And EA wasn't the sole proprietor of NFL titles. Only X.A.N.A had competition. And it wasn't just a fucking monopoly in the console space.
Thanks for joining us tonight, along with Darren Pang, Mike Emmerich. We're just about set to drop the puck. We're ready to get underway in Detroit. Faceoff won by Oates. Didn't get through. McCarty retrieves it. Right side to Yzerman. Osgood, there to make the stop. Yzerman retrieves it. That one out of reach. Along the board. Dancing in. Right to Murphy. Shoot. Cross ice pass. Kolsig races back to get it. Just out of reach. On the wing. He was belted by Oates. Kicked out by Osgood. Cutting in. Saved by Osgood. Detroit. Back to get it. Cutting in. Kicked out by Osgood. Tenorti starts it the other way. Rister. Washington chases it down. Gathered in by Juno. Got a blocker on it. Comes to Juno. Yzerman in the corner. Tenorti takes a little shove. Finds Oates. Rockets one. Cutting in. Caught by Osgood. In back of the goal. Finds McCarty. The Capitals set up shot. Big save. Leads it along to Oates. On the wing. Sends it off the boards to Bondra. I'm running down in the period. Saved by Osgood. Big blast. Yzerman skates his way through the neutral zone. And that'll do it for the first period. Detroit, 0, the Capitals, 0.
We got the zzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzzz I think I know what Ira Ira Beal is. It's the irritating stick. A game that would indefinitely be better on the Switch than on the PlayStation. Unless, we're playing it with the PlayStation VR. Flips over way too easy. Okay, so Rallycross 2 isn't nearly as bad as Rallycross 1 was, but still though, not a racing game I would actually go out of my way to try. You see the crowd would be absolutely scared shitless out of their minds. Ain't worth it. Thank you.
うっちゃんなんちゃんからの挑戦状。完全攻略できたら100万円。もう夢じゃない。全人類へ向けられた悪意がここに。勝つのは人かマシーンか。さあ、炎のチャレンジャーよ。今こそ立ち上がるがいい。選択可能な
Motherfucker! We're back in a second.
I'm working too hard for these things. I gotta subscribe.
You too can subscribe. 4 times a year, you get 2 CDs packed to the hilt with game demos, video interviews, event footage, downloads, and more. All this for only $29.95 a year. In the meantime, check out this issue of the Underground Jam Pack and see what you've been missing.
So we are back, folks. So there's a promo and really bad shit. So behind the scenes with Crash Bandicoot.
Warps!
So this time we're going to be fighting against Tiny in the Colosseum. He's a Roman gladiator.
Hey, Mark. What's going on? We'll give you up.
Thanks for the underground footage. We'll put you in the next underground. Credits, okay, huh?
An R&D.
You love to play games. If you're a subscriber to the PlayStation Underground CD magazine, you also get to help us make one. It's a mini game called Project Wormhole. Race a futuristic car down a tunnel and dodge enemies and obstacles. Over 4 issues, we've been showing subscribers how it comes together. See how the car is built. Test it hands-on. Watch the tunnel come together. Use our tunnel editor to make sections of your own. Learn how the vehicle gets put into motion and detects collisions. And check out the basics of artificial intelligence and sound effects. Viewers have been sending in suggestions for the game as it's built to www.playstation.com. If we like an idea and use it, that subscriber's name might just end up in the credits. This is a hands-on introduction to building a mini game, something no other magazine can do. It's the kind of insider experience available only on PlayStation Underground CD Magazine, the magazine you play. Give us a call and get connected.
Yeah, this was one of the coolest things about the PlayStation Underground. Grant, now these jampacks are like preview discs. More so than anything of what the actual PlayStation Underground is. So, yeah. In the usual code vault. So. But anyways, that's all, folks. Peace out.